Hey guys, Zello1626 here. Gonna be doing a little something different on my channel this time. This is the Pokemon Trading Card Game. This game came out for the Game Boy in, obviously, 1998. It is pretty much a handheld version. Oh, hi, hi lag, how you doing? A handheld version of the actual trading card game that was released and became like a huge thing. It was such a huge thing back in the day. I actually got started on it myself. I had like a whole fucking box of cards because my friend, he worked at like a little kiosk in the mall that sold like, it was like a seasonal job he had. They sold like board games and trading cards and all that stuff. So he got a bunch of the trading cards from there. He gave a lot of them to me, kept some for himself. He actually got a full set of one of the actual, whatever you want to call them, the sets for the different expansion packs or whatever they had. Whatever you want to freaking, I don't remember what they were called. But I still have my book of cards somewhere. I'll have to look for it. I think I know where it is. But anyway, that's not the point here. Let's start a new game. Maybe. My game would stop lagging. Be fantastic. Let's put in my name. Zelos. Zelos is crazy about Pokemon and Pokemon card collecting. I used to be back in the day. One day, Zelos heard a rumor. The legendary Pokemon cards, the extremely rare and powerful cards held by Pokemon Trading Card Game's greatest players. The Grandmasters are searching for one to inherit the legend. Dreaming of inheriting the legendary Pokemon cards, Zelos visits a Pokemon researcher, Dr. Mason. Off to the Mason Laboratory! Oh, why the rush, Zelos? What? You want to learn how to play the Pokemon Trading Card Game? So you two finally want to start playing the trading card game. Yeah, I already know how to play the trading card game, but unfortunately you're gonna teach me, aren't you? Well, dueling is more fun than just collecting cards. First, you should try playing with a practice deck. Here, I'll give you this deck. And now you need an opponent. Hey, Sam, play with him for a while. Sam the Alpier? Holy shit, I didn't know he was in this game. Sam! Yes, Dr. Mason. Hello, Zelos. Okay, let's give it a try. Hey Zelos, hurry and come here. Okay. First, ask Sam the basics of the game. Okay, Zelos, what do you want to ask about? I have nothing to ask because I will explain as I go. Attacking, retreating, evolving, using Pokemon power in your turn, win or loss of a duel. Is that all? Yes. They say that actions speak louder than words, so let's play a game. Since this is your first time, just try to learn the basic steps. I'll be coaching you, so follow my advice. If you don't do as I say, you won't be able to proceed. It might be easier if you read the Pokemon Trading Card Game instruction booklet while we play. Okay then, let's start your practice game. Sam is a tech. Holy shit. Since this is just practice, do not shuffle the deck. Each player will draw 7 cards. That's standard for every game, you draw 7 cards. Choose a basic Pokemon to place in the arena. Draw 7 cards. And get ready for the battle. Choose your active Pokemon. You can only choose basic Pokemon as your active Pokemon. So you can choose either Goldeen or Staryu. For a practice duel, choose Goldeen. Goldeen level 212 was placed in the arena. You may choose up to 5 basic Pokemon to place on the bench. Next, put your Pokemon on your bench. You can switch benched Pokemon with your active Pokemon. Again, only basic Pokemon can be placed on your bench. Choose Staryu from your hand and put it there. Place Staryu on the bench. When you have no Pokemon to put on your bench, press the B button to finish. Placing the prizes. In this practice duel, you only get 2. Most games are 6. It's up to 6. That's like this. In the actual trading card game, it was 6. It was always 6. But in this game, it varies from 2 to 6. A coin will be tossed to decide who plays first. If heads, Zelos plays first. This coin flip is always heads. For the practice duel, it's always heads. beginning of your card, you draw a turn, and I got a water energy. To use the attack command, you need to attach energy cards to your Pokemon. Choose cards from the menu and select the water energy card. Next, choose your active Pokemon, Goldeen, and press the A button. Then the water energy card will be attached to Goldeen. Finally, attack your opponent by selecting an attack command. Choose attack from the menu and select Horn Attack. Now let's play the game! Now, we can check what is in our play areas. He has a Machop, I have a Goldeen. Pokemon power, we're not going to learn about those just yet. We're not retreating, we're not done. So let's go to our hands, see what we've got. We've got a full heal, a Sea King, a Psychic Energy, water, and three Water Energies. So let's attach one of these to Goldeen. Attached Water Energy to Goldeen. And he said to use Torn Attack, so let's do it. Machop took 10 damage. Each attack will do a different amount of damage. And it will vary based on if they are weak to it or not. But we'll get into weaknesses and stuff later. Attached Fighting Energy, Machop. Now that attack is going to do 20 damage to our Goldeen. Goldeen only has 40 HP. We may be in trouble. Your Goldeen's going to get knocked out. Let's evolve it. Choose Seeking from your hand and attach it to Goldeen to evolve it. Its HP increases from 40 to 70. Your Seeking doesn't have enough energy to use Waterfall. You need to attach a Psychic Energy card to Seeking. Star means any energy card. Now you can use Waterfall. Keep the Water Energy card for another Pokemon. Now let's attack your opponent with Seeking's Waterfall. Let's play the game, let's do it! Let's attach the Psychic Energy to Goldeen. Lag, please, go away. You're pissing people off, man. 1 second. I closed out a couple things that were open that didn't need to be open. Now let's evolve our Goldeen. Goldeen evolved into Sea King. Now we can use, whoops. No attack, damn it. Waterfall. Sea King's Waterfall. Whoa, the lag is real, holy shit. Machop took 30 damage. Sam, it's your turn, go man. What are you doing? Place Rattata on the bench. Attach Fighting Energy to Rattata. Machop's low kick. I think that's his only move. Another Water Energy. Sea King's got enough energy, so you don't need to attach any more. Attach energy card to your benched Pokemon to get them ready for battle. Attach a water energy card to your benched Staryu. Next, select the attack command. Machop has 10 HP left. Sea King's Horn Attack will be enough to knock out Machop. Now choose Sea King's Horn Attack. Now Machop's HP is 0 and it is knocked out. When you knock out the defending Pokemon, you can pick up a prize. Oh my god, the lag is real. I'm gonna have to see what I can do to fix that. Holy shit. Let's give a water energy to Staryu. Kill this fool with Horn Attack. And Machop is down. Machop was knocked out. Zealous will draw one prize. I think they're both the same. Yeah, they're both water energy cards. Sam placed a Rattata level 9. Sam has a Rattata. Oh lord. Rattata evolved into Raticate. Catch lightning energy to Raticate. Raticate's bite. Hey! You stop that. I don't appreciate your shit. You do drowsy, level 12. When all your Pokemon are knocked out and there are no more Pokemon on your bench, you lose the game. Put drowsy, the basic Pokemon you just drew, on your bench. Attach a water energy card to drowsy to get it ready to attack. Choose your active Sea King and attack your opponent with Waterfall. Now let's play the game! So let's put Drowsy on our bench. Give a water energy to Drowsy. And attack with a waterfall. It's pretty much telling you what to do here. Obviously. Now later in the game, you're gonna get a lot more cards and you can strategize a lot more different ways. There's so many different ways you can strategize in this game. And down goes our Sea King. Sadly, I could have killed him there. Oh well. Sam will draw a prize. Select a Pokemon to place in the arena. Choose a benched Pokemon to replace your knocked out Pokemon. You now have Drowsy and Staryu on your bench. Choose Staryu as the active Pokemon for this practice duel. Here, press select to check Pokemon data. It is important to know your cards and the status of your Pokemon. Now let's play the game! Staryu! Draw one card. You always draw a card at the beginning of your turn. Ooh, a potion. Staryu evolves into Starmie. Let's get Staryu ready to use Starmie's attack command when it evolves to Starmie. Choose the water energy. Choose the water energy card from your hand and attach it to Staryu. Attack your opponent with Staryu Slap. Alright, let's do it. Let's give him a water energy. Boop. Attack with Slap. Bitch, please. Sam's turn. Place Machop on the bench. Attached fighting energy to Machop. Raticate retreated to the bench. Machop's low kick. Draw a card. You drew Seaking. Now recover Staryu with a trainer guard. Choose potion from your hand. Now let's get ready to evolve it to Starmie. Also attach a water energy card to Staryu. Attack your opponent with Staryu Slap to end your turn. Let's play the game. Time to play the game! Use potion. Staryu healed 20 damage. Give him another energy and experience a little bit more lag. Fantastic. Let's slap this fool. Bitch slap him! Attached fighting energy to Machop. Machop's low kick. Hey! Guy? I appreciate your shit. There, Starmie! Now you have finally drawn a Starmie card. Choose Starmie from your hand and use it to evolve Staryu. You've already attached enough energy to use Star Freeze. Attack your opponent with Starmie Star Freeze. Now let's play the game! Of course they're gonna have different attacks than they do in the actual Pokemon games, but that's how the trading card game works. I mean, some moves are the same. There's like Water Gun, and I think something has Hydro Pump, doesn't it? Thunderbolt, Thundershock, and all that good stuff. Tackle. Low Kick's actually a move. But anyway, I digress. Let's evolve Starmie. Or Staryu into Starmie. Oh, whoops. Attack with Star Freeze. Starmie Star Freeze. Paralysis check. If Head's opponent is paralyzed. If they are paralyzed, they won't be able to attack you for one turn. It can get healed with the full heal cards. There's other statuses, but we'll get into those when we get into those. Draw one card from the deck. Attach fighting energy with Chop. Finish the turn without attacking, because you can't attack when you're paralyzed. Machop is cured of paralysis. My turn! You gonna die! Now Machop has only 10 HP left. Let's finish the battle. Attack with Starmie Star Freeze. You've knocked out your opponent. Pick up the last prize. Zealous is the winner!
Yay!
Get out of here! Doesn't matter at this point, you're dead.
You're gonna die!
Machop was knocked out, let's take our final prize! We are done! Yay! We won the duel with Sam! Basically, this is how the Pokemon trading card game is played. It's a game in which you try to knock out as many of your opponent's Pokemon as there are prizes. That's the gist of it. If you don't understand something, talk to Sam. It might be helpful to practice this again, too. This time was just practice, so I had you follow everything I said, but there are other styles of play. So try them out by choosing Normal Duel. Now then, let's build your deck. Did you bring your cards? Handed his cards to Dr. Mason. Now let me add some of my own cards to yours. Now, Zealous, what kind of deck do you want? Please select the deck you want. Charmander and Friends, Squirtle and Friends, and Bulbasaur and Friends. I think Bulbasaur and Friends is the best deck in here. Squirtle is good, and Bulbasaur, so Charmander is not that good. I mean, it's an okay fire type, but I don't care for Charizard, like, at all. So... Squirtle or Bulbasaur? Bulbasaur. Yes. Because my first Pokemon ever was Bulbasaur. So I gotta go with this. Bulbasaur and Friends deck. Here are their remaining cards. I received 30 cards. You should duel with many different people. Why don't you go to one of the card clubs? There are many people playing at the clubs. Collect new cards and try building a new deck. Alright, hey, I can actually do stuff. Let's go to our deck. Let's see what's in our deck. We got a Bulbasaur, an Ivysaur, Venusaur, Caterpie, Metapod, ooh, Nidorans. Nidorans are good. Especially Nidoking is amazing in this game. Tangela. Flareon. Seal, Dugong. Dugong is awesome. Krabby Kingler, Golding, Sea King, Vaporeon. Pikachu, Raichu, Magnemite. Ooh, the Electabuzz card! Oh, the Electabuzz is good, too. Oh, Hitmonchan, too? Oh, this deck is amazing. Abracadabra, Ghastly Haunt, or Jinx. Jigglypuff, Meowth, Kangaskhan, Eevee, Professor Oak. Discard your hand, then draw 7 cards. If this is the only card in your hand, it's good to get more cards into your hand. Bill's always a good one to have. Draw 2 cards. Switch one of your benched Pokemon with your active. I'll get into what these all do later. But for now, I'm taking out that plus power and I'm throwing in Bill. I definitely want a potion in my deck. Revive. And of course, energy cards. You'll need those to actually use your attacks and whatnot. Confirm. Save. Yes. Now you can build a new deck if you really wanted to. Which I am going to do if I can. I don't think I can. Let's see. I may not have enough cards to do this yet. There is a nice little trick to get more energy cards very early if you have the opportunity to do so. I may not be able to do it just yet. No, I don't have enough cards. Dismantle. Yes. I will get into it when I get into it. Now, Diary is your save option. There we go, and that will do it for this part. I'm sorry for such a long tutorial crap. But we'll get into more of this game in the next part, guys. So next time on Pokemon Trading Card Game, we're gonna head out into the world and see what the hell we can do. See you guys later.